Kia ora, my cute little woodland creatures. The time has come, my loves, for some rather overdue shoutouts, to use the parlance of our time. So, back in December or possibly late November, I can't quite remember which, I made my first video for YouTube. And it was shit! It really was. Firstly, I was using that really, really crappy mic that made me sound like I had a lisp, which was awfully embarrassing. And secondly, whatever it was I was trying to say in that video, I felt I was doing a really piss-poor job of saying. And I felt that my only real option was to delete that video and have another go. And I was amazed to discover that in the 16 or so hours between uploading and deleting, somebody had actually subscribed. And I'm thinking, who the hell would subscribe after a video like that? And the answer to that question was Lovely Elk, a gestalt entity consisting of two crazy Californian girls named Emily and Corey. And what they were doing was this very, very cool comedy double act that it was random, silly fun, purely for the sake of random, silly fun, and I found it absolutely delightful. So what you all need to do is go and watch the Lovely Elk videos, because they are brilliant. Unfortunately, Lovely Elk appears to be on indefinite hiatus, but Corey has a solo project going called Valley Girl Party, which is also random silly fun for the sake of random silly fun, and has the advantage of being a current going concern. So you should check out Lovely Elk and Valley Girl Party. Incidentally, I assure you, Corey doesn't sound even slightly like Moon Unit Zappa. So. I really think that individual shoutouts are in order here. So, Corey, I'll start with you. The stuff you said about me in your shoutouts, naked vlogs, and liking rap music video was so utterly, utterly lovely. Thank you very, very much indeed. You're an absolute sweetheart. I blushed and I melted and I squeed and everything. Thank you so much. You are an absolute sweetheart. Mwah. And Emily. Emily, I absolutely love you to the tiniest of pieces. I really, really do. I've totally enjoyed chatting with you online, and I really hope that I see you on YouTube again really soon, because I really miss you. So yeah, Emily, mwah. Now, my loves, I would like to say a huge thank you to Miriam from Ashra.com. Miriam, you have been extremely cool to me lately. Thank you very much. You see, darlings, Miriam has informed me that I'm allowed to use music by Manuel Göttsching in my videos. Manuel Göttsching started a band called Ashra Tempel in the year 1970 when he was 18 years old. And it was this band which, in my view, bridged the gap between rock music and the newly emergent electronic kosmische music, which was beginning to spring up in Berlin around that time. Manuel Göttsching is my absolute favorite guitarist in the world. He is an amazing guitarist, and this is coming from somebody who, for the most part, cares not for guitar music. I find that for the most part, guitarists tend to be more interested in showing off how fast they can play and looking cool and impressing the girls than actually composing and playing music. But that is what Manuel Göttsching does. And the stuff he comes up with is just beyond belief. In 1974, he released his first solo album, although it was listed as an Ashra Tempel album. It was called Inventions for Electric Guitar. He was the only musician on that album, and the only instrument was the guitar. And the piece that I'm using in this video, called Echo Waves, comes from that album. The second track on the album was called Quasarsphere, and that's where I got the name that I use here on YouTube, and AIM, and Skype, and Christ alone knows how many internet forums. What I think you should all do is go to www.ashra.com, and you'll find out absolutely everything you need to know about Manuel Göttsching and his music. And one cool fact, actually, do you guys know who Timothy Leary was? Those who don't, he was a Harvard professor, and he was the guy who made LSD very popular. He had what was known as, with his students at Harvard, he did this thing called the electric Kool-Aid test, in which they'd all take LSD, and the authorities in the States wanted to shut him down, so he found himself getting hit with, I kid you not, a 20-year prison sentence for the possession of two joints. And he escaped from prison in the States and fled to Switzerland, where he teamed up with Ashra Tempel, and they recorded the album 7-Up. With Timothy Leary as the lead singer. Now, how fucking cool is that? Go to www.ashra.com and find out everything you need to know about Manuel Göttsching and his music. And my personal recommendations, my favorite albums, would be Inventions for Electric Guitar, the live album Sauce Hollandaise, which has an amazing half-hour live version of Echo Waves. And the album Die Mulder, which was released in 2005, is just so fucking beautiful. It's beyond belief. So yeah, definitely people, check out Ashra / Ashra Tempel / Manuel Göttsching, because, well, it's made my life better, and it could do the same with yours. And Miriam, once again, thank you very, very much indeed. Mwah. Alright, loves. One more thing that I need to discuss, and that is the naked vlog meme. Oh yes, somebody has decided that it would be a good idea for people to make YouTube videos in the nude. Well, here is the deal, my sweethearts. Tomorrow, I'm going to check my PayPal account. If my PayPal account is still empty, then I will do a naked vlog. You've been warned. And that's all I've got time for right now. I've enjoyed chatting with you, my sweethearts. Kakite.